First tiefling character, and of course being goofy little me, I decided to try and play a bard. Hardcore. All points in charisma, intelligence and dexterity, and dump everything into perform. My instrument of choice? Well, my sister had gotten a violin, so I wanted to try and playing a fiddle. Worked in the DM's book, so he agreed that he would tolerate my tiefling, named Beel, because I have no originality. Beel was a simple bard of many tastes. He loved booze, women and songs. Oh, he did love songs. You see, as we levelled, I essentially dedicated at least 2/3 of my points into perform because, honestly, I enjoy being the centre of attention when out of combat. Beel would step into a tavern, hear the lute and say, "Shit ain't gon' fly!" And you can bet your sweet ass that we'd be having a good old-fashioned hoedown in that place before the third drink in. Half the time, the party made me go in first to get free drinks and rooms. Beel never needed one. He would find a tavern wench and fiddle her through the night. More than a couple of sessions went by, which ended with Beel pulls out his fiddle and starts this shindig. But there was a story, because Beel was so great at fiddling and partying and making merry, he sucked royally at actual combat. Not that it was a big deal, I mean, I wasn't an idiot. Stayed back, boosted the party, and laid the chicks that needed laying. I gave them breakfast in bed every time though, because Beel is a gentleman man slut. Problem with that is when you need to help, because otherwise you look like a tool who's riding his team for free stuff. So I promised the group that when I saw a chance, I would take it. Then came the bridge with the devil. Oh, the bridge with the devil, he had a violin. So Beel somehow manages to notice that the devil near the bridge happens to have a violin. The DM said something about him looking like a performer, but all Beel heard, all I cared about, was violin. So instead of rushing, I asked him to wait it out, just a bit, while Beel waits for his moment of calling. The entire party begins passing sneak checks, which were easy due to thick as hell underbush, but Beel is the only one rolling perception. What did he learn? 1. The devil seems to be part of a travelling circus. 2. The devil appears to have a huge bag of gold that seems to be a toll for the bridge. 3. He's pretty damn good at the violin he had. Our wizard reminded us that apparently the town had come under siege from the local devils, who were charging toll on everything and everyone. This was important, sure. But did Beel care? A little. Was it his motivation? Hell no. We sat in that bush for 2 in-game hours, waiting. Until that bastard suddenly started playing his violin. By himself, of course. In the middle of the woods. I listened to a few songs, the party growing anxious, before finally seeing him start really shredding that violin. This was it. This was the moment of truth. Beel watched the devil, smiled, and quietly told the party, "I've got this, fellas." Beel leaps from the underbush, his violin in his storage box, and a smile on his face. He stuns the devil for a moment, who looks up and stops playing. The two infernal creatures lock eyes for one glorious moment, and the devil stands up with his hand holding the bow but reaching for the dagger on his hip. "Who are you?" Beel bows slightly and introduces himself as a weary traveller who's way behind, and he's willing to make a deal. The devil, intrigued by Beel's monstrous amount of charisma, decides to hold off on killing him. The rest of the party slowly starts to step from the bush, Beel ignoring them as he sweet talks the monster and tries to convince him to accept the challenge. The DM makes a roll, checks it, and then informs me that the devil is open to your idea. This was when Beel strikes. Quick perception check, I notice a felled tree and began my narration. Beel hops up on that hickory stump and says, "Boy, let me tell you what, I bet you didn't know it, but I'm a fiddle player too. And if you care to make a dare, I'll make a bet with you. Now, you play pretty good fiddle, boy, but give this tiefling his due. I bet my party's gold against the bridge toll to think I'm better than you." Utter fucking silence. The entire table is quiet as they stare at me, having leapt up from my beanbag chair and singing the entire thing. I wait for the DM's response, but he does the best thing any human can possibly do in such a situation. The DM turns round to his laptop, types up a few things, and suddenly the music begins to play. The group looks a little confused, and the DM stands from his own chair, a smile on his face, and then he narrates. Oh god, am I going to have to sing?
Yeah.
The devil says, "My name is Carnia, and it might be a sin, but I'll take that bet you're going to regret, because I'm the best there's ever been." Oh my god, this is like Tenacious D. The group is utterly lost, and the music hits the first lull. It was an instrumental, no vocals, so it was just the drum and guitar. The DM suddenly pantomimes leaning over and putting something down. The devil opens up his case and says, "I'll start this show." And fire flies from his fingertips as he raises up his bow. And he pulled that bow across his strings and it made an evil hiss. And a band of gibberlings joined in and it sounded something like this. That's when the first player falls over laughing, but I'm not. Bale knows music is the most serious of all battles. Bale waits for the tempo to change, listening and watching as this devil unleashes the nine hells in his sick fiddling. The DM asks someone below to roll a few times to get some numbers for gameplay purposes. By this point, the music is blaring as loud as possible, and any airspace not filled with the most epic fiddle tunes to grace our ears is filled in by laughter from the group. As the tune finally comes to an end, the DM bows and sits down. He pretends to point the bow to me and continues. When the devil finishes, Bale says, and I take up my role as the most bardcore of all. Ew. "Well, you're pretty good, old son, but sit down in that chair right there and let Bale show you how it's done." And what did I do? I sung and started skipping around the room, jumping on chairs and sliding around the room as I pretended to be the bard I knew in my heart Bale was. I did everything I could to make him proud, even trying to make my fingers look realistic as I pranced like a fool to the laughter of my friends. And as Bale's retort slowly winds down, I get right in my DM's face and pantomime pulling the bow across the strings with the most devilish grin I can muster, leaning over him in the most awkward if alpha stance I can muster as my legs still shake. The DM pauses the music and starts checking the numbers we rolled, adding in everything. At first, it doesn't look good for Bale, who was actually facing possibly one of the best fiddlers in this plane. That was until we hit the final three rolls and added my perform skill in. I actually scored about 70% of the score after all the math was done. Bale had fiddled the fuck out of that devil. The DM smiles, turns around, turns the music on, and narrates once more. The devil bows his head because he knew that he had been beat, and he lays the bridge tool down in the ground at old Bale's feet. As we laugh, I scoot away, pointing the imaginary bow I carry towards him. Bale said, "Come on back if you ever want to try again. I should have told you before we started. I'm the best fiddler there's ever been." And for a glorious moment, we all sang together as I pranced around the room once more, my feet growing slightly numb as the people next door probably confused as to why the neighbourhood has the best fiddle music this side of the river. As the song wound down, my best friend jumped up and grabbed my shoulder, and the best of the group applauded. I did it. This was it. This was bardcore. From that point on, I made it a point to challenge fiddlers. I never sung against them, simply challenged them and tried to make some coin. Bale finally bought his way in and managed to become part of the team. The best part was after that session, I asked the DM if he had set that up for me. He had, but we were supposed to kill him for his violin. Months later, the DM informed me that we would be reusing the same characters as part of an epilogue, part of a special story, and he informed me that Bale would once more need to fiddle, but that's another story. Well, for you guys, since you ask, it had been almost a decade in-game world, and since we left off, our characters had essentially gone their separate ways. The initial plot was gathering everyone back together to become the dream team of the fantasy world. We thought it was kind of cool. Since most of the characters were young, we managed to still play characters in their 30s and one in their 50s, Paladin, Super Bro. The rest managed to form up without much problem, and then the group made a note that something was amiss. Then the thief asks, "Where the fuck is Bale?" Enter me, suddenly handed this sheet of a character aged a decade, but was as surprised as hell. The DM had given Bale a fucking theatre he played in every other night. He was apparently Barty Hardy every spare moment of his life. He drank, he gambled, and he slept. In a decade, Bale had never settled down, but in all fairness, he was just as much of a gentleman to the ladies he was partying with, which left him a rather decent reputation. How did the party find Bale? Why, under a group of partygoers, a mug hanging off his horn and a shit-eating grin on his unnaturally youthful, eternal face. "Been long enough, fellas!" Bale gathered his gear, paid for the night, made his latest roomy breakfast, and set out with his friends, happily fiddling as he set out along the road after them. And so the party sent out after the new threat, unaware of their higher purpose. As the party journeyed from town to town, they noticed strange things. Well, they did. Bale noticed the ladies and a few bars, but otherwise he was blind. See, in the time since we left the characters, they had become rather famous, rather heroic figures that were little like celebrities. When they entered a town, everyone noticed them, and reacted with joy and cheer, and sometimes flat-out fan clubs appeared. Everyone was famous, except for Bale. For some reason, people ignored, if not hated, Bale on sight. I had to roll performs to get them back to a neutral state, and then perform my way into their hearts again. Not that I was complaining about barding up a storm once more, but out of character, we all took note of the weird censor that people had on Bale. And by extension, me. I had performance points no moral bard had any reasonable right to have, which meant the couple of bar fights I got into were pretty damning from the gameplay point of view. But Palabro was there for the healing. Had he not been there healing me, the angry fanatics that crept through the window would have clubbed me to death. Oh yeah, there were angry fanatics that crept through my window one night to kill me. By the way, they were the first lead we had. Turns out, there was someone casting high-level mind wipe and suggestion spells that erased me from everyone's memories and made them subtly hate me for no goddamn reasons beside DM reasons. As we progressed, it got worse and worse. Only thing that kept my party on my side was nightly fiddle session that restored their memories of me. Shit was getting intense. We continued to move forwards, growing closer and closer to the source. There were people that would literally attack me in the streets when they figured out who I was. It was kinda suckish, until I could sneak into the tavern and perform to the entire crowd to praise and love. By the time we reached the castle with the big bad evil guy's initials written on the front door, we were tired, battered, and sick of people trying to kill the musician for no reason. We ascended the stairs, defeating deluded warriors and bandits forced into service, Bale providing commentary and epic background music the entire time. As we draw closer to the top, the DM informs me I hear a light sound, almost like a string instrument. Oh, you did not. Seriously, DM? We throw open the doors and see, surprise, it's motherfucking Carnia. Turns out I didn't just outperform this bastard, I destroyed him. And he hated me. Oh, did he hate Bale. He had devoted half a decade to plotting against him, and the next half carrying it out. Everything had been because Bale had destroyed him, and he was surprised when he saw the rest of the party, not even remembering their faces. All he cared about was me. It was then that I realised that the DM was leaning back, and he handed me a sheet. His next move was to click something on his laptop. The paper in my hand? Lyrics for Devil Comes Back to Georgia, which he had no idea was an actual thing. And the music started. Carnia cast some sort of infernal tangle on the party, and suddenly the entire tower gives way to reveal that it's the center of a mass, and I mean mass, teleport spell. He ports half the world into this little enormous arena thing, creates magic speakers, and then the DM clears his throat to announce to the world his challenge. It's been 10 long years since the devil laid the bridge toll at old Bale's feet, and it burned inside his mind the way he suffered that defeat. In the darkest of hells, the devil hatched an evil plan to tempt the tiefling fiddler, for he's just a mortal man. The sin of pride, the devil cried, is what will do you in. You thought you had this settled. You're the best fiddler ever's been. I sat there listening to the music as the DM continued, the rest laughing around me as their characters are grappled and left to watch this infernal showdown take place. Then the DM continued, Bale, didn't you know that time keeps marching on? The coldest hours in Eberron come just before the dawn. Devil's back in game. Will you stand the test? Or will you let this devil be the best? And that's when Bale cracked his neck, drops and kicks his case open, and places the fiddle under his chin. As I improv the lyrics a smidge, improv class does wonders for roleplay, don't it? In truth, I haven't played this character much since June. But give me half a minute, he'll get his fiddle back in tune. I watch the lyrics, which he's nice enough to point out a few key things to change in my direction. And true to the tune, the devil whooshes over and steals my bow and fiddle, and the DM tells me he starts to play. The devil grabs the older fiddle out of old Bale's hand and says, though I was a fiddler underground, now I walk the land. The DM stands up, pulls out an inflatable violin he found and starts to pretend to play, dancing and keeping beat with the music, which even though was new, I could feel a familiar beat and found myself not worrying about keeping up the improv. DM stops and points to the party that sits tied up, laughing hysterically and rolling his performance, and continues, "Y'all just better be turning back if you want this tiefling to win, cause natural's the only cure for the targets he's gotta hit." I grin and read from the paper and add my own touch. "Now devil, it was sin for you to fudge my rolls. You go on back to hells and to the tavern I will go. Old Bale, are you practicing or will your rolls go low? This DM rolls the devil's hard and there'll be no re-rolls. Can you hear the party crying? Will they ever know? This devil wants Bale's very soul." The DM throws me a fiddle and I slip off my shoes and socks, stretching my toes out as the music starts to come back around. I grin and test the inflatable fiddle out, bending my knees as I get ready to bardcore once more. The music comes to me. I point the bow and happily state, "Before we play, I want to thank you for letting form boards ring true. They said DMs can't be trusted." He smiled and laughed. "Yes, but what you gonna do?" Bale smiles and readies the bow. "Well, you can have my character sheet if you think that you can win, cause I outrolled you once with this here bard, and I can roll them once again. And you can bet your collective asses I pranced around that room like a fucking swan princess, trained by the Blue Fairy and private tutelage from the Russian ballet classes. Did I look like an idiot? Yes. Did I make myself look like a fool? Oh yeah. Did my knee hurt for a month because of this? You bet. But I'll be damned if I did not follow the bardcore I wanted to be. Slime cubes green, tieflings red. Can't fight shit, sing instead. This devil's dream is that he can win, but Bard Bale's the best fiddler that has ever been." I slid to my knees as I finished my solo, making the holes that would eventually lead to the ruin of one of my favourite jeans, and nearly crushed my little toe. I'm not a small dude at all. I was panting. The group was laughing and clapping, and the DM was trying not to fall over out of his beanbag chair as I stuck my tongue out like a rock star and held the inflatable fiddle over my head. The DM finished the rolls, calculated the performance scores, and handed me the sheet. This time, Bale had finished with a little over 80% of the total allotted point scores in the game. The entire world cheered as Bale stood up, bowed, and then promptly danced around the devil who collapsed into a terrible mess on the stage. One of the greater evil gods appeared, and was so moved by my performance that he apologized, took the devil Carnia back to his plane, and promised to prevent him from bothering me, lest my fiddle skills start to flatter because of the distraction. After that, the party once again went their separate ways, eventually passing into legend. The paladin bro became the right-hand enforcer of his god. Well deserved. Dude was more devoted to Cord than any bastard before him. Godspeed, man. The thief finally landed the biggest payday imaginable and retired to luxury, but not before buying an orphanage, a promise from the first campaign she played. The wizards founded a school of magic, divided into two sides, and I have battles between the two classes every week to decide the lunch menu. The warrior reclaimed a long-lost throne and refined a kingdom of magicless people with nowhere to go. And Bale? Bale continued the tradition of Bardcore, eventually reaching peak status as a star of his own tale. And after years of continuing the fiddling of divine aptitude, he achieved godhood as a god of music. His clergy currently practices the fiddle, and he is invoked every year to duel the best. Should he judge them worthy, he bestows a golden fiddle of performance. I refuse to play Bale again, mostly because I can't do it better than that, and partly because I've moved from bards. But I will never forget the bardcore.